What is going on, everybody? Gordon Ottav here for the G Show. Welcome to yet another episode. This is episode number 45. We've got some new lights going on here, and I'm excited for bringing you more value with this episode. So let me know in the comments below where you're coming in, where you're tuning in from, and as we go along, we're gonna give you some shout outs. And if you're watching this replay, let me know hashtag replay if you're watching the replay as well. So as I said, I've missed last week, so we're back with another episode of the G Show. And in this episode, we're gonna talk about 7 priorities for maxing out production in your business, in your network marketing business. And these are some great priorities that you should absolutely implement if you want to take your production and your team production so it will expand gradually within your team and duplicates within your team. So again, we're going to talk about the priorities. What are these priorities that you've got to understand, and why they are very, very crucial in implementing immediately. Okay, immediately. So I hope that this will bring you value. Share this around. If it does, like, comment below. Let me know your thoughts about what I'm gonna share with you in here. And this is also a special week as well. Probably you read the title. It's my birthday week, so I'm gonna comment one of my first comments later on after I finish this. Look out for the comment. So that's pretty something awesome. If you want to make it great, not just for me, but something that we're creating this legacy project, and you can help out as well. Again, you'll find that in the comment, one of my first comments below. So I'm gonna talk about. Let's get into the information here, so we don't waste any time, any precious time. So the first one, okay, first priority to max out production is your personal production. Okay, so your personal production sets the pace. So you putting in the work, you just doing what are the income producing activities, doing the growth activities as well, will help you set the tone for your team, set the tone for creating momentum in your team. What's up, Jelena? What's up, Shaheen from UK? So we've got Latvia in the house, and also UK. Good to see you here. So that is number one priority. And we started with this one pretty simple, because it starts always with you. Okay, it is your business. You must understand, if you're watching this, we do this targeting people who are seasonal servant leaders, or people who want to become servant leaders in our profession. This is who we are targeting in here. So if you're the first time you're watching this, welcome to these shows. You can watch all the other episodes either in here or on my YouTube channel. Okay, we put them all there for you to watch and share with other people if you find value in these lives. So it starts with you. So you got to set the pace. You've got to go and do the work. You've got to start putting in the work if you just got started. And a lot of people mistake this because they're waiting for somebody to move their cart, okay? To move their cart into the supermarket to start shopping, putting in the stuff in the cart. No, it's you. You've got to push the cart. You've got to select the items. You've got to put in your stuff. And this is exactly what you should do. It must be a priority. So if you've got people in your team already, you've got to prioritize this with them, that it needs to start with them. A lot of people go into study mode instead of action mode. So if you have people who just join your team and they are studying, I don't work with people like that. And I had a lot of people, and I had recently also people who join and they want to study everything without putting any ounces of action. And this is when they start dwelling with their doubts, dwelling with everything, because they did not understand this, and it's not income producing activity. This is why this is for maxing out production. This is not production if they are looking to know everything about the company, about the products and stuff like that. There are other people who can help them in that process, And as they go along, as you go along, you get to know stuff. Okay, you go to events, you go to attend a webinar, make a call with your sponsor and upline, you get the hold of that. Okay, what's up, Malcolm? Good to see you, buddy. I will send you a message later on, important message. Thanks for seeing you here. I reminded to send you a message. So that's number one. Let's move on to number two, is highlight your producers. Okay, this is something that I started doing more frequently in the last 12 months, is highlighting those people who really saw the vision, are implementing the actions, are attending events, are really there focused on doing and creating something special. So people who you don't need to tell them that there is an event coming up, you don't need to tell them that there is a webinar that they should attend, or a leadership call that you set up, or maybe somebody else from your organization, but they are always there and they do the work, they do promote it with their team. Okay, this is what I call them, the top producers in your team. So you've got to highlight them. So have regular communication with them. And this is will save, number one thing is will save you a lot of time. See, most people try to work with those who need, who are needy. A lot of people, this is why they waste a lot of energy, unfortunately, and we did that in the past. Don't worry if you're doing that. So you can fix it in any time you want. And instead of focusing on those who really are doing something, are putting in the 10%, okay, or 20% at least, and creating something, they're doing what it entails. They're showing the information. They're getting people in. They're putting eyeballs in front of the information, right? The information about your products or services, or also the opportunity, right? So you've got to have regular communication. If you have someone who you're in contact with, some people who have different results than you, make a call, arrange a call with them, okay? Have them share their story and maybe share some of other tips, and invite those people. Invite these people who are your producers in your team, okay? So having regular communication, it is also a must. You can create nowadays WhatsApp group for them as well, just to make a connection, to keep that connection going. You can organize a quarter like calls, like Zoom calls with them, okay? And one other thing is that this is something that I learned in the process as well. Do not focus a lot on trainings. There is the company trainings that does a lot of things. I don't know which company you're with, doesn't matter, but talking to the company that I am with, they have phenomenal events, and my goal is to not give them a lot of training that they arrive at a moment and a time that then when the event comes up, they don't come, they don't attend, okay? You have to focus on how I can make them win. How can I help them get to the next level? How can I help them putting more into their business if they want to, okay? I don't push people to do this, to do things, okay? I'm looking for people who rise, okay? In fact, servant leader rise. You're not born as a servant leader, but you rise. And the only way you rise is because you're doing the work, you're putting in the work, and you are surrounded by the same kind of people, same type of people as well, right? So have regular communication with them. So that's number two. Number three is schedule blitzes and team building events, fun team building events. So what do I mean by scheduling blitzes? So you can use technology in your favor if you've got international team, for example, like I do. And sometimes it's a struggle because I don't like the word struggle, but if you have people with different languages, can you do that? Yes, you can, okay? Yes, you can. All you need to do is to plan ahead these blitzes. So whatever it is what it does, when you create blitzes, you start creating momentum in your team. So you can do, like, if you're using technology, if you have, let's say, people from different countries and you're using technology like Zoom, for example, you can schedule like every 2 hours an event, a presentation, a story, people sharing stories from your team, okay? And people can invite other people, and this is how, I mean, they can be people that they came from your blog, or they came from you meeting them in a coffee shop, or maybe in a networking event, whatever it is. It's exposure after exposure, and this, because you have people from your team sharing their story, it is something off the hook. And this is why more people get more excited about what you're having, excited about what you're doing as well. So move people to see more stories, to listen to more stories, because this is one of the most powerful things in the profession is stories. Okay, normal people having extraordinary results as well. So make sure you do that as well. So team building, okay, create small events. You don't need to rent big plays and you put DJs and stuff like that. Don't start with that. You just start something like maybe an event with family. You can go to a park or something like that. You can organize a picnic, or you can organize and do some games. Okay, make it fun. Okay, make it fun. And this what happens, it happens that you are helping the getting into a level, deeper level, when it comes to loyalty. And this is something that people will start to really understand what is the mission of the team, really understand you, why you want to help them more, why it goes deeper than that, okay, than just selling a product or a service, okay. The friendship relationship goes higher, okay, not just deeper. And the energy, their energy, okay, if you've got a lot of energy, if you've got a lot of passion, you can transmit it, not just from technology, but when you are with them, they get it, they get the energy. And a lot of people try to learn, and I hope that some of you already know that people want scripts. What do you say? They ask me this, what script should I say? What line? It's not about scripts, guys. It's all about your energy, okay? Your energy is the script, okay? Don't focus on if you missed a line or something like that you've learned from some events or some trainings that you've attended, but it's the energy that is the most important thing. In fact, I was with someone in my team a few days ago, and she was hesitating to do presentations and to show the opportunity because she did not know much, because she just got started. And I told her about the energy. I told her, focus on the energy. And this is when she realized that it is true, because after she did what I showed her, she got her first people joining her team. So again, it's all about that energy, and it helps when you do organize the team building events. So also more production when it comes to that. So number four, fourth priority is knowing when is the closing period from week to week, okay? In your company, you must know when is, for example, in my company, Friday is the last day, okay? So Saturday is the start of the week. So Saturday till Friday, you know, okay? You know which is the start and the end period time of the week. So knowing that, you can monitor, especially if you, at the end of the month, last week, couple of weeks till the end of the month, you should see who are those people who are near, who are close to hit the rank in the company, or maybe a special bonus in your company. And you've got to help those people. You've got to communicate more, and you tell them, how can I help you? How can I help you to go to reach your next rank? Be available for them, okay? Make yourself available, and this is very, very crucial. A lot of people focusing on their goals only, not on helping their team reach their goals as well. So, I mean, I had people reaching their one of the special bonuses in our company by the end of the month. For just few dollars left, they could have made $1,000 extra, but because they did not want my help, okay, their ego level went up, and who missed them, okay, at the end of the day. So this is why it's very important to make it a priority to maxing out production. So find people you can work with. a lot of people, you can find people who have high egos and stuff like that. That's okay, it's part of the game. But who can you help? Ask this question, who can I help now? Okay, if I go to your system, who can I help that are close to reach the next rank in the company? And this is, again, people start, you start creating momentum as well because you're helping people. Don't just focus on your goals. So have it, check out the timelines, whatever it is, the bonuses in your company. Maybe it's a new promotion in your company that you see people participating as well. Just get in touch with them. Get in touch with them and help them out to reach the next rank. So number five, okay, fifth priority is utilize incentives, okay, to move people to action. I love this. It could be small. Okay, don't start with something big. Okay, start with something small. Maybe start with a book. Start with a special training event, or maybe if your sponsor Upline, who is a top commander, is close by. Okay, you can arrange a call. You can arrange a call or a dinner or a lunch with them. Okay, see if you can make it happen. It's not something big, but it's just an incentive. Okay, an incentive for those people who moved into action. So give them something fun to shoot for. Again, it could be a book, it could be something significant that can help them in their self-growth or into growing their business. This is one of the things that I share with people, okay, that can give us an incentive. It can be something like a dinner with somebody that can give them more value. Okay, not just dinner, you know, a pizza or something like that, just that, okay, alone, but get them together. Maybe five people hit a special rank, or maybe they reached a goal in the company, in the team that you gave them. Okay, get them together, five of them, and maybe do something fun, go out and have fun, eat pizza or do things like that. Okay, it's the bondings that masterminding that will help more energy created in the team, again, for maximizing out production. So number six, we're getting close to the end of this. Thanks for those who are tuning in. Shout out to you. What's up, Reina and Goran, Anna Goran, Laura from Italy. Good to see you guys here. And thanks for those who are sharing, clicking the like or the hearts as well, if you're finding value in this life. So let's go to number six, deep and meaningful recognition. Okay, recognition. Are you recognizing your people? Are you recognizing people in the team? Okay, even people that just signed up somebody, just one person. Okay, people will fight in wars, but they will kill for recognition. People will fight in wars, but they will kill for recognition. So understand this, you've got to have a deep and meaningful recognition for them. Okay, call them up, not just post on Facebook, send them a text, send them a private message, leave them voice call, okay, whatever it is, and just have that deep connection and meaningful recognition for them. Okay, not everybody is gonna reach certain amount of ranks in the company or a rank that you have reached perhaps, but with just doing that, okay, people will feel celebrated, and this is very, very important, okay? When you celebrate others, then eventually people will start celebrating you, my friend. So recognition is incredible, okay? People will produce more also by feeling that atmosphere of being celebrated as well. So number seven, let's go to number seven, double time during closing periods. Double time during closing periods. What does it mean? Okay, so when it's time to closing in the week, okay, when it's time to closing in the week or the month, okay, see who is performing in your team. See who is moving forward, okay, with growing their business. And what you've got to do is to absolutely double your time. This is what it means, double your time. You've got to go all out. Some people even fly to different country if you're a certain level in leadership, okay, to help that market, okay, okay, because you found some leaders there in order to spend not just money but also time. That's why doubling time to increase and to go help them go to the next level. And when it comes, as I said, in a week, when it comes in my company, Friday, okay, Friday is the last of the week. So during Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, okay, see how you can be available for them, okay? Let them help them understand why it is important to, so they can hit the next thing in your company, okay? What is important to hit the next bonus or the bonus, one of the bonuses in your company, what difference can make, not just for them, but how it impacts their team as well. So, this is another thing. You've got to use your time wisely. Again, as I said earlier, not those who needs your time, but who deserves your time. A lot of people just want to manage or maybe help everybody. Again, we did this in the past, but nowadays, that's why I'm focusing on the right ones, focusing on those who really, really want this, okay, really want what you're doing. So to sum this up, okay, those were the seven priorities for maxing out production. I hope that you find a little something or a lot of value in this. If you did, please share this around, comment below, leave a comment below, click like or wow, or share this around in your team groups. Again, helping servant leaders out there in our profession. So having said that, this is another episode of the G Show. Thanks for watching, guys. Again, look out for the first comment that I'm gonna leave in this below this post, so you can find also a way how you can give back forward. It's birthday week, my friend, so excited for the next couple of days as well. So for more information, or if you want to catch out all the other episodes, go on my YouTube channel, youtube.com/GordonAttard, or to reach out for more articles and related to the profession, go on GordonAttard.com. That's my website, and we can connect also on there. Having said that, have a great rest of the week, my friends. God bless. See you on the next episode, always in here, the 46th, and have a great rest of the day, my friends. Take care. Bye-bye.